Hello everyone, welcome you all. My name is Pavan. So in this video, I'm going to talk about what are the differences between list, dictionary and tuple. So far in the previous videos, I have discussed about list, and we have seen so many operations on list, and also I have discussed about dictionary and tuples. Now in this video, I'm going to show you what are the basic differences between list, dictionary and tuple, and where we need to choose or when we need to choose list type or dictionary type and tuple type. Now let's get started. So list versus dictionary versus tuple. Now let's see one by one. So if you want to create a list, we have to use this bracket like this. So list variable equal to, we have to specify few values. So this is the creation of list. And if you want to create a dictionary, so this is a syntax we have to follow. Dictionary variable equal to, dictionary means it should have a key as well as value pair, right? So the values will be stored in the pair. So here we have two things, two parts. These are not like a normal data, right? So here we have a value corresponding key, key and corresponding value, and then second key corresponding value. And here we need to start with the curly braces, right? This is a dictionary creation. And if you want to create a tuple, we can just create tuple in different ways. So we can create tuple like this. We can open brackets, all the values we can insert in the double quotes by separating comma. This is one of the syntax, and we can directly specify the values to the tuple without having brackets. And we even also we can store the strings like this and without brackets. So there are multiple ways of creating the tuples. And now come to the another difference. Suppose if you want to extract the value from the list, I want to extract one of these value from the list, I have to specify the index number. So when I say print list of 0, so in the 0 position 10 will be there, right? So this will be printed, it will return 10. So if, by using index, we can extract the value from the list. But in case of dictionary, we can extract these values based upon the key. So when I say here dictionary of key, the square brackets, when I pass the key, this is our key value, okay? When I pass this key, and it will return the corresponding value. So what is that? 30. Okay, so this is how we need to retrieve the values based upon the keys in dictionaries. Now when you come to the tuples, again in the tuple also we use index number to get the value from the tuple. So let's say tuple name of in the bracket, we can just pass an index number, and based on this the value will be returned. Now in the list we can store duplicate values. So in this list we can store the duplicate values. List is allowed duplicate values. But in the dictionaries also, keys are not duplicates. Values can be duplicate. So duplicate keys not allowed, but duplicate values can be allowed. So we can have multiple values, but we cannot, the dictionary cannot allow duplicate keys. But the, because the keys are always unique, but the values can be duplicated. And when you come to the tuples, tuples also allow the duplicates. Just like a list, tuples also allow the duplicates. We can store the same numbers again and again. But when you use tuple, this is a little bit faster than list. Okay. Now, so suppose in the list, if you want to assign the new value. So for example, I have declared a list and I already assigned some values there. Let's say here 10, 12, 14 we have. In the zero position, we have a 10. Now in the same position, I want to insert a new value in the list. I can simply say list of 0 is equal to 100. Now what happens is in the 0 position 100 will be inserted, rest of the values will be shift to the next position. Okay, so here adding, inserting, removing, okay, and reading the, everything is possible. When you come to the dictionary, if you want to update, we can just update the only value, not the key. So we have to specify the key and equal to, we can update the value. So currently here Mary is equal to 30. Now here I have updated with the 35. So dictionary of key value, this is our key, and this is your new value. This is your new value. So if you want to modify this value, we can still modify. But why it is possible modifications and adding a new elements in the list and dictionaries? Because these are mutable. So mutable is nothing but once we have created a list or dictionary, we can modify that. Modification means we can add new elements, we can shift to elements, or we can remove the elements. So all kinds of actions we can do on list and dictionary. So that means a mutable. Mutable means modifications are allowed. And when you come to the tuple, tuple is immutable. So that means modifications are not allowed. So let's see this example. So currently tuple 1 is declared, let's say tuple 1 is there. So in the zero position, there are some values. Now I'm trying to put a new value here in the zero position. So what it is giving? It will give you type error. Type error it will give you, because in the zero position already there is some values there. So we cannot add or we cannot insert in this middle, or we cannot remove the element from the tuple. So all those actions are not possible. So because this is immutable. So values can't change once we have assigned. Values can't change once we have assigned, because tuple is a mutable and dictionary list are mutable and the tuples is a immutable. Okay. Now lists have to create by using these brackets, square brackets, and dictionary is creating using curly braces, and now tuples are creating open braces. These are called square brackets, and these are called curly brackets. These are called open brackets. Okay, that's the difference. Now slicing. So we have done slicing almost every type of data, right? So slicing is possible in list. So slicing means we can extract these values by specifying starting index and ending index, right? So when I say 1 colon 2, it will start from 1. So 1 means it is 0, 1, 20 is position 1. So from there to second. So 0, 1, so 1, 2, so 20, 20. So 1, 0 is here, starting index. And ending index 2, right? 2 means we need to count from the 1. So 1, 2. So same position. So slicing can be done in the list. But in the dictionaries, we cannot do the slicing. We cannot do the slicing. We cannot do the slicing. So we cannot get the values from one position, one to, because it will not maintain any proper order. Okay, that's the main. So here in the tuples, we can still do the slicing just like a list. So suppose here I have a tuple. And if you want to get 1 comma 4, it will return 1 means start from 20, 4 means 1, 2, 3, 4, till 40 it is written. So slicing is can be done in the tuples. It is exactly same as a list. But when we need to use these types? So usage is, so list we have to use if you have a collection of data that doesn't need random access. If you have collection of data that doesn't need a random access, then you can go for list. So the other use is when you need a simple or iteratable collection that is modified frequently, then you can go for list. But when we need to go for dictionaries? So you need to go for dictionaries when you need a logical association between key and the value pair. So again, we need to decide based upon the data. If you have multiple keys as their values, we can just go for dictionary. And when you need a fast lookup for your data based on the custom key, then you can go for dictionary. And when we need to go for tuples, so use tuples when your data can't change, because this is immutable, right? So tuple is immutable. So whenever we say tuples, we cannot change the data. Okay. A tuple is used to combination with a dictionary. For example, a tuple might represent a key because it's immutable. So in the dictionaries, keys are immutable, but keys are, we cannot change, right? Values of the keys can be changed. The same kind of behavior we have in tuple also. But in the dictionaries, keys cannot be changed, values can be changed. So in the dictionaries, keys are immutable, but values are mutable. But in when you come to the tuples, all the values are immutable. We cannot change any values. So if you don't want to change any values in future, then you can just go for tuples. Okay. So these are the basic differences between list, dictionary, and tuples in Python. Okay. So that's all for this video. So thank you all. Please subscribe my channel to get more updates on this. Thank you all.